For example, I have a magnetic field vector represented by vector B, and it is equal to 5 Tesla. So I can represent this vector as an arrow. This is a typical drawing of an arrow. Now, if I look at the arrow when the arrow is pointing away from me, then what I can see is the crosshairs of the feather. When the directions of the vectors are represented by this symbol, then we call the direction of such vectors as into the page. On the other hand, when I look at the vector in this manner, then what I can see is the tip of the arrow. And when I represent vectors or magnetic field vectors this way, a bunch of circles with dot in the middle, then it is understood that the vector is pointing out of the page. Now let's have a review of the right hand rule. When your charge or when your current has a velocity vector that is represented by this green arrow, and it is being affected by a magnetic field B represented by this blue arrow, then the resulting force due to this magnetic field, we call this magnetic force, is perpendicular to the plane created by the velocity vector and the magnetic field vector. So we call this plane as the VB plane. To guide us, we use the right hand rule number 1. The first right hand rule guides us in determining the relative directions of the velocity vector of the charge or current and the direction of the magnetic field and the direction of the resulting magnetic force. So to determine the direction of magnetic force, you just have to point your fingers to the direction of the velocity vector of the charge or the current. And then the palm should point to the direction of the magnetic field. When you try to curl your fingers towards your palm, then wherever your thumb points to is the direction of the positive magnetic force. If the problem gives us the direction of magnetic force instead, then you just have to use right-hand rule to determine the direction of the velocity vector of the charge or the direction of the magnetic field. Next, we discuss the right-hand rule number 2, or the second right-hand rule. The second right-hand rule is used to determine the direction of the resulting magnetic field due to a moving charge or current. So for example, in this setup, the current is moving to the right. You just have to point your right-hand thumb into the direction of the current and try to curl your fingers along this wire. So whatever the direction of your fingers would be the direction of the magnetic field lines. Don't forget to like this video, subscribe to my YouTube channel, and hit the notification bell button for awesome updates. Thank you for watching!